Let's go, Falcons!
Hey, yo, batter up. Let the brawl begin. Solano Falcons, about to show you how you win. Cause this is our year. Man, forget the past. We take it over right now with our pitching staff. When the count's 0-2, every hit is so through. Fastball right by him. They had no clue. It makes a jaw drop. They got no choose. Strike three, you're out, homie. Let him know, blue. Solano to the plate and you know it's on. He swings for the pitch. It's going, gone. So don't try and step to the Bay Valley champs. Cause we're coming for the pennant. This the Wallachian, yeah. We might strike it out. Or we might steal. Or may a go-go play in center field. Solano baseball, all have tight skill. All stars everywhere with highlight reels. Everybody watch out, cause when it's game time, we going for the W, gonna make our name shine. Falcons dominate when the game's on the line. So go get your belt, Solano. Why? Cause it's game time. Ayo, it's game time, so let the games begin. Solano on the field and we gain in a win. Ayo, it's game time, don't you hear the people chant? Cause that's this right. Is our house, make way for the champ, it's game time.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another Solano Falcons baseball game here on the Solano College Sports Network. We're here at Billy and Luis Yarborough Stadium in Fairfield, California. I'm Tristan Vector, joined by my broadcast partner, Brian Marciano. Today's game is brought to you by JamesThomasMedia.com, your stop for all your video production needs. We got a great matchup for you today. The Solano Falcons have definitely stepped up their play since the conference play started, and they're now 2-2 in the BVC, pitching much better. The Folsom Lake squad is very, very powerful. 13th in the state in home runs, led by Nick Schumacher with 4 of their 8 home runs. Brian, what do you expect from tonight's game?
Yeah, no, actually, last time we talked about the pitching. Today, the hitting's going to be a key. Yesterday, Solano lost to Laney 5-1 and only had 3 hits. And Coach Stover has actually mixed up the lineup. We'll get to that in a moment. Do you want me to give Folsom's lineup right now?
Yeah, let's go with Folsom's starting lineup.
Absolutely. Leading off is Joseph Smith. In the two hole is Tyler Kame. He's in right field. Catching today is Mason Allen. He's hitting third. The before mentioned Nick Schumacher is playing first base and hitting cleanup. Cale Leach is playing third base and hitting 5. Greg Vaughn is in left field hitting 6. Joel Perdetti is the designated hitter. He's hitting 7th. Charlie Harbor is the second baseman, hitting 8th. And hitting 9th is Michael Majeski. He's center field. Pitching today for Folsom Lake is Ryan Vlasic Pickle. And so those are the lineups. Back to you.
All right, so we'll send it over to the Solano Falcons starting lineup now.
Evan Facenda, Vanden High School.
Jesse Phipps, Laguna Creek High School, right field.
Joey Dotson, American Canyon High School, second base.
Briar Litz, Foothill High School, catcher.
Luke Noble, Placer High School, center field.
Tyler Stover, D. Vacaville High School, first base.
Jack Pridey, Napa High, third base.
JoJo Quintanilla, Dixon High School.
Garland Webster, Army High School, shortstop.
Jackson Berry, Oroville High School, pitcher.
Welcome back. We're about to get underway with the first pitch of the ball game today. Brian, you mentioned earlier some of the changes in the Solano Falcons lineup from yesterday and from the regular order. Why don't you talk a little more about that?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's just looking at they lost 5-1 yesterday to Laney and only had 3 hits. So manager Stover probably wanted to, I don't know. It's not like he threw the lineup up in up in the sky or something, pulled out of a hat, but he's definitely switched it up here, and I don't know, maybe that's got to be a good thing just to have guys hitting in different positions.
The Falcons have come out much better pitching-wise here in conference play. 3.50 ERA as opposed to nearly 11 in non-conference play. They've really pulled it together. Jacksonberry on the mound today. What do you expect from him?
Yeah, no, I'm thinking he's just got to keep the ball over the plate and, maybe try to give up three or four runs and then let the hitters do what they do and hopefully Solano can pull out a victory.
We've never seen a ball go over the fence in any of the games that we've called. However, if there is any chance for that, today is the chance. Folsom Lake, 8 home runs on the season, 13th in the state. One of those players, as we mentioned earlier, Nick Schumacher, has hit 4 of the 8.
Yeah. No, we don't want to be rooting for the visiting team, but what I just want to see a ball go over the fence today, Tristan.
Well, hopefully it's for the Falcons.
No, but that's the funny thing. Which Falcons?
That's a good point, too. If you didn't know earlier, Folsom Lake is also named the Falcons. It's right. Falcons versus Falcons today.
Yeah, we're on the internet. You think the Atlanta Falcons might be watching back in Atlanta?
I don't think so. Number 7, Joseph Smith, will lead off for Folsom Lake, the shortstop, against Jacksonberry for the Falcons. First pitch missed. It's ball 1. And the 1-0. Outside again, 2-0. Joseph Smith batting .324 this season. 4 runs batted in. That pitch is in there. Strike 1 from Jacksonberry. And that's in there, too. 2-2. 2 nice pitches from Jacksonberry.
Yeah.
Big key for the Falcons today is to stay ahead in the count, pitching-wise, that is, getting strikes over the balls. There's a swing and a miss. Struck him out. 3 straight strikes from Jacksonberry and a great start to the game.
You can't start any better than that.
That'll bring up number 23, Tyler Kame, right fielder. Tyler Kame. Kame's their other big power hitter. 2 home runs out of the 8 with a .385 runs or batting average.
I'm noticing here that he and Schumacher have been playing together a long time. They both went to high school up in Folsom at Vista del Lago.
That pitch is out low and outside. Here's the set, and that pitch is fouled back, 2-1. Berry with the set, here comes the 2-1. Low, 3-1. And that pitch is swung on and bounced to short. Garland Webster up with it. Throw to first. 2 up, 2 down.
Wow.
Good job by Garland Webster on the routine ground ball. That'll bring up Mason Allen, catcher. Batting .241. 1 home run, 9 runs batted in. That pitch looked good, but it's a little high. 1-0.
Mason Allen is from Orangevale. He went to Oakmont High School.
Here's the 1-0. That also looked pretty good, but it's a little inside. 2-0. And here comes the 2-0. That's outside, 3-0.
You want to throw a strike here, but you can't just send it right over the plate.
3-0 pitch. Just outside again. All four of those pitches, all balls, but they were all right around the strike zone. So it still looks kind of, I would say, encouraging for Jackson Berry right now because all those pitches were good misses.
Absolutely. But he does have to be careful now with the before-mentioned Schumacher.
Very dangerous hitter right here, Nick Schumacher. Batting 304, four home runs, 19 runs batted in 18 games this season.
Yeah, he's got to be one of the best community college players in the state.
First pitch outside. Coach Stover going to go out to the mound and have a chat with Barry, probably about how to handle Schumacher in this situation.
I would think so. I mean, it's been a real good start, and it could change in a hurry here, so that's what he's probably reminding him of.
Schumacher back in the box now. Berry with the set. And that pitch is low. No, it's in there. Bottom of the strike zone. He got the favorable call from the umpire. Here's the set. And the pitch. Swung on. Shot to right. Coming over to Stover, and he dropped the ball. That's going to allow a runner to get to third. He's going to hold there. Schumacher will hold at second. And actually, my bad, that's Jesse Phipps in right field.
Yeah.
We're used to seeing Stover over there, but he's at first base today.
Exactly.
And you mentioned the lineup changes.
See, not only the lineup at the plate, but the lineup in the field. And, yeah, maybe he's not accustomed. I mean, that certainly seemed routine. That's a catch you got to make.
First error of the season for Jesse Phipps. And now the situation has greatly changed from no one on, two outs. Kale Leach, number 44, the third baseman for Folsom Lake, is at the bat now. And he calls time.
Yeah, you know, it's just like anything in life. You know, the pitcher thought he was going to be out of the inning here, and he's not. And now he's just got to face an extra hitter.
Leach, batting 288, has a home run, five runs batted in. The four players on Folsom Lake who have hit home runs this season come back to back to back to back to back. 2, 3, 4, and 5 for Folsom Lake. So this is the tough part of the lineup.
Yeah.
And the pitch. And that's in there for a strike. Nice breaking ball by Barry. And time called by Kale Leach. Barry taking his time right now. He is in no hurry, making sure.
Well, he should take his time here.
Yeah, he's trying to make sure he makes the right pitches. The set, and it's outside.
You don't want to put him on, but, I mean, that's an option, you know.
With a base open, you get to a less powerful hitter in Greg Vaughn. And you have more options for your fielders. They could get in out at any
base.
Right,
that's true.
As there's a swing and a pop-up in foul territory. Stover with a long run.
Yeah, wow.
And he is not quite able to make the catch. Great effort by Tyler Stover.
That would almost been like Willie Mays over the shoulder in the 54 World Series against Cleveland.
Yeah, it was very, very similar basket catch over the shoulder, but he was unable to make the play. Now Now, with two strikes, you can forget the walking option. You want to really make a good pitch here in a 2-2 count. The chance to strike him out, maybe end the inning. The 2-2. And
nice.
He got him. Strike wow. three. Great breaking ball. And a heck of an inning for Jackson Berry. At the end of the top of the first, we have zeros here in Fairfield. Now we will send it over to McKenna Guerrero.
Hey guys, McKenna Guerrero here reporting live from the Billy and Louise Yarborough Stadium. Right before the game, I was able to speak to Coach Stover, and he said there are quite a few changeups in the Falcons starting lineup today. Sophomore Briar Litz will be catching and playing cleanup for the first time this season. Evan Facenda will be leading off. Tyler Stover is playing first base. Garland Webster is hitting ninth. And right before the game, Michael Driscoll was taken off the starting lineup due to a wrist injury. Coach Stover also stated that the Falcons need to get back to doing things that got them their previous victories, such as routine plays, playing catch defensively, and throwing a lot of strikes. Thank you, and we'll be right back for the bottom of the first.
Welcome back. Bottom of the first inning here in Fairfield, and a great report there by McKenna bringing us the information on the lineup today. Michael Driscoll's last-second injury is a big deal for them.
Right.
Starter in pretty much every game this season.
Exactly. No, McKenna really did a good job. We speculated on what was going on by talking to Coach Stover. She got the whole story, and it's never good when somebody right before the the game happens, but it happens a lot, and they'll have to make the best of it. More importantly, that first inning, that's a great start to the game. You know, to get the two out strikeout with the guy on second and third.
Yeah, and you know, he wouldn't have been on the hook for those runs because of the error; they would have been unearned. He really took his teammate Jesse Phipps off of the hook
right. Because
Phipps was the one who made the error. Yeah. But you mentioned also Stover, with changing the lineup so much. You got guys in positions they're not usually accustomed to playing, and
sure.
Then you have mistakes like that potentially happening.
Yeah. But the
Evan Facenda bunts at the first pitch, pulls it back.
But whatever happened, it didn't even matter. You know.
Yeah, well, it's in the books now, and there was no run scored in that inning. So.
Yeah, exactly.
Facenda's the DH today as he takes a pitch on the bottom of the strike zone. Wow. Really look below the knees there.
Yeah. No, it's rare. I watch some baseball. You very rarely see the DH leading off.
Usually they're around the cleanup spot, 3-4-5. Facenda's hitting .386 this season. He shows bunt, pulls it back, 2-1. The Falcons, I noticed this morning, are top 10 in the state, I think 8th, in their sacrifice hits and sacrifice flies, their 9th. So they like to play small ball as there's a bouncer to short. Scooped up and thrown to first. Facenda's out. Nice play by Joseph Smith, the shortstop for Folsom. Another routine play. One up, one down. And that'll bring up Jesse Phipps with a chance to maybe get some redemption at the plate.
Yeah, that's it. Put that first inning mistake behind him and get a nice hit here.
Jesse's batting .268, 6 runs batted in. He's played 14 of Solano's 15 games. Shows bunt, pulls it back, pitches low for a ball. And now the pitch, he shows bunt, he pulls it back. Falcons really seem intent on getting a bunt for a hit potentially, or at least showing bunt.
Yeah, well, maybe a base runner is a base runner.
It just gives Folsom like extra things to think about too, and it brings the third baseman and first baseman in on the grass. This is a pitch in for a strike. Ryan Vlasic, the pitcher for the Folsom Lake Falcons. You made the joke about the pickles.
You understood that one, yeah. That's the one thing, Tristan. Hold on, we got to go.
Bunted down the third base line, picked up and thrown to first, and he's out. Nice play by Cale Leach.
Yeah.
Third baseman, you were saying?
No, you mentioned the Vlasic pickles. I'm just not a big pickle guy. Whenever I go to a deli and they give me like a pickle on the side, it ends up in the trash can. Do you like pickles?
I do not.
Yeah, exactly. Some people, yeah.
So that's what we get up. Yeah, they disgust me.
That's how I feel. I mean, I might have like one pickle on a sandwich, maybe. But that's even too much, you know. And so, yeah, but pickle by itself, no chance.
That'll bring up second baseman Joey Dodson, the number three hitter today. Takes a pitch inside. Joey batting 304 on the season, four runs batted in. And the set, here comes the pitch. Inside.
Yeah, Dotson's probably never hit into the third hole in his life.
Here's the set. And that swung on line right back up the middle. Base hit and a solid swing from Joey Dotson on that pitch. First hit of the game for either team.
Okay, we got a replay. It's a nice.
Yeah, just a rope right back up the middle. A lot of people don't realize, they think that where the ball goes on the swing is just random. But the thing is, if you swing a little early, it goes to the left side. If you swing late, it goes to the right side. And if you hit it right perfectly, it goes right up the middle. That's how, you know, the angle of the bat works. So Joey Dotson really timed that one perfectly. Yeah. And sent a rope right back up the middle. And you mentioned Briar Litz. First time as catcher, first time as a cleanup hitter.
Well, a lot of firsts here.
He shows bunt, pulls it back. It was a strike. 235 batting average this season. He's driven in two runs. He's played in just 9 of the 15 games this season. Now the set. Pitch is low. 1-1. Now the set. And the delivery. Joey Dotson going. Oh. He picks him off. Joey might make it to second. He's going to be cut down. Great job by Ryan Vlasic on that pickoff throw to first, and he caught him running.
Exactly. No.
That was a great move. And that'll end the first inning. We're still zeros here between the Falcons and the Falcons. We'll be back with the second. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the second inning. Two really well-pitched innings in the first from each team. Greg Vaughn will lead it off, followed by Joel Pedretti and Charlie Harbor, the 6-7-8 hitters for Folsom Lake. Here's the set. Jackson Berry starts off the inning. swinging a bouncer right back up the middle. No chance for Garland Webster. That's a base hit for Greg Vaughn. Wasting no time, Greg Vaughn with the first pitch of the inning. That'll bring up Joel Pedretti, the designated hitter today for Folsom Lake, and the first lefty hitter that I've seen today. Pedretti has only played three games this season. This is just his third at-bat. He's 1-for-2, so technically batting 500 off of just two at-bats.
It's a very small sample size.
Berry checks the runner on first. And the set, it's runner's going. Swinging a bouncer back up the middle. And Webster touched second one. He was unable to turn the double play. The throw was a little off, but a nice play by Webster. Heads up to get that runner at second, even though he was going.
Yeah. No, Vaughn was coming. Here's the Vaughn's coming right at him.
You see him just step there in the nick of time at second, and the throw was just off by a few inches to cost them the double play there. Coach Stover's out to talk to the umpire at second.
Is this the greatest difference in height between an umpire and a coach ever?
Yeah, that's at least a foot. That looks like Shaq in a point guard. Well, whatever the decision was, he's out, and the runner at first is safe. Yeah. Stover's not happy. He thinks it was a double play. I think it was the right call.
No, I do too. He definitely was pulled off the bag. Charlie Harbor.
All right, that'll bring up Charlie Harbor, one on one out. Pitches outside, throw down to first. Oh, that was a quick tag by Stover.
Yeah.
Close play at first. Harbor digs back in. Berry checks the runner at first, gets the set. And time called by Harbor. Berry taking too long for him. Now the set. And the pitch. Swung on. Roped to second. What a play. Throw to first.
Wow.
They got the double play. What a play at second by Joey Dotson. That ball screeched right at his face.
Well, he almost had to.
And he turns it to Webster, then to Stover. There you see it on the replay. 4-6-3 double play. That'll end the top of the second inning. We'll be back with the bottom of the second. Still 0-0 here in Fairfield. Welcome back. Bottom of the second inning. The 5-6-7 hitters for the Falcons.
Yeah. But going back to that double play, Joey Dotson almost had to make that play to save his life.
Yeah, that ball took a short hop and went right back at him. He had to make a spinorama underhand throw to Webster, and then they got it to first. I was wrong. It's actually the 4-5-6 hitters. Litz was up last inning when Joey Dotson got picked off, so he will start up this inning again, and he swung and missed at that first pitch.
That's right. He gets to bat in both innings. The officially now.
You notice Mason Allen get up and walk around for a second. Looked like the bat of Litz kind of caught him on the backswing.
Yeah.
On that last swing there, he was a little bit close to the hitter.
I can't even imagine being a catcher. You have a hockey background. Is it similar to being a goalie's got to even be worse?
Yeah, you should ask my brother. He's the goalie, but I have no idea, honestly. You're watching 100-mile-an-hour slap shots or 100-mile-an-hour fastballs coming at you.
Right.
I'd rather not do either.
And the little difference here, at least you know what pitch is coming.
That's a good point. You can call it. It was a pitch outside. One and one on Litz. Swinging a shot to left base hit. Line drive screamed off the bat of Briar Litz. That's the second hit of the game for the Falcons. And good for Briar Litz, too. You mentioned a guy who just, he doesn't start a whole lot.
No.
He's never played cleanup before, never played catcher.
Making the most of an opportunity.
Yeah, it's a good start to the game for him. That'll bring up the center fielder, Luke Noble. Noble batting 182, 4 runs batted in 12 games this season. Shows bunt, the runner bluffed going, and he pulls the bunt back. Vlasic with the set. Noble showing bunt again. And that pitch is low. He pulls it back. 1-1. Noble showing bunt again. And he gets this one down right in front of home. Coming over to play it is Vlasic from the mound, and he'll make the throw to first, but the job is accomplished. Luke Noble gets the bunt down. Briar Litz moves to second base.
That's pretty much a textbook.
And he gets this one down right in front of home. Coming over to play it is, you see the replay. Vlasic did a good job, too, to be heads up. A lot of times, because you see that in the pros, that's what they're supposed to do, but a lot of times at college and high school level, the pitchers aren't as quick to get off the mound and help out on a play like that.
Right. And then the catcher made a clear pointing, go to first base.
Yeah, the catcher's job in that situation is just to make sure he knows.
Yeah.
Because he wants to get the guy at second if that's possible.
Yeah.
So that'll bring up Tyler Stover. First pitch is in there on the outside corner, strike one. Tyler Stover batting 313, 10 runs batted in this season. Vlasic with the set. And the 0-1. Swung on a foul right back. 0-2. Last time we were out here, Stover ripped.
All those doubles.
A five hit, or what was it, a four hit game?
Exactly. Now, one, he got a single when he should have had, remember that?
He should have had a double or maybe a triple,
exactly.
But the base runner ahead of him kept waiting to see if it would get caught.
I'm pretty sure, didn't the guy get pulled from the game?
He did.
Yeah.
He got pulled immediately. Swinging a shot to second. That's going to get over into the right center field.
That's a run.
Gap. That's going to score a run. Stover starts to round first. He's going to hold with a single, but RBI single for Tyler Stover, and the Falcons are on the board first.
That's awesome.
Of course, the Falcons were going to be on the board first in a game between Falcons.
Yeah, that's a given.
Now batting, third baseman.
11
third
runs batted in on the season for Stover. That'll bring up Jack Pridey, the third baseman, number 11. You see the replay there. Just over the outstretched glove of Charlie Harbor, he gave it his best leap that he could, but you know, apparently he doesn't have enough hops. This is once again proof that white men can't jump. Now the pitch. Pridey drops the bunt down. Vlasic out to get it. He's going to throw it to second. And they got him. Nice job by Vlasic to be heads up. And a nice job as well, equally by Charlie Harbor to make that catch. Yeah. That was a bad throw.
It was.
So that bunt did not get the job done. Now we have a runner on first and two outs. So that'll bring up JoJo Quintanilla with a bouncer to second. And easily played there by Harbor to Smith. That'll end the second inning, still 0-0 here in Solano.
Oh, I got a run.
Oh, 1-0. You're correct. Falcons have the lead. Top of the third inning here, the Solano Falcons are going to be playing with the lead for the first time this game as they lead it 1-0 off the Tyler Stover single.
Yeah.
9-1-2 hitters. Michael Majeski's going to bat, and then the lineup will flip over to Joseph Smith and Tyler Kame. Majeski's the center fielder. 214 batting average with 4 runs batted in this season. First pitch is outside from Barry. Here's the set. And the 1-0. That looked good, but it's apparently outside a little bit. 2-0. Now the set. 2-0 pitch. Right down Broadway. It's 2-1. Now the set, 2-1 pitch. That's right down the middle again, 2-2. Now the 2-2, just low and outside, 3-2, full count. First full count of the day. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swung on and fouled back. Majeski just trying to stay alive on that heater.
Yeah, it was right down the middle.
Barry is really throwing some gas right now. Here's the set. 3-2 pitch. And he just misses high. That's a walk. Second of the game for the Folsom Lake Falcons. That'll put a leadoff runner on for Joseph Smith.
Now batting shortstop, Joseph Smith.
Smith struck out swinging his first time up in the first inning to start the game. Smith showing bunt. Pitch is high. 1-0. Now the set. And it's high again, 2-0. Seems like Barry's trying to pitch around the bunt and avoid it, but, you know, it's just a free out. And a lot of times I feel like taking the bunt's better than trying to pitch around it and end up walking the guy.
That's probably what they're talking about the mound right now.
Smith digs back into the box. Barry with the sign, 2-0 pitch. Right down the middle, bunted back to the mound. Barry will pick it up and make it to first. Easy play. One out. Runner on second now.
Now batting. Right fielder, Tyler Kame.
That'll bring up Tyler Kame. Grounded out to short his first time up. Webster made a nice play. Barry with the set. And the pitch. No, he bluffs it. Too big of a lead there at second base for Michael Majeski. He didn't like it, so he took a step off. Now the pitch. In there, strike one. Barry checks the runner and checks him again before pitching. Swing and a miss. Heck of a breaking ball from Jackson Barry inside. Handcuffs Tyler Kame.
No, wonderful pitch.
So that's the 0-2. Jackson Barry is ahead in the count. One of the keys we said earlier for their pitching.
Most brutal pitch from behind in the count.
It's just so much easier to stay ahead. You're pitching from it's like a downhill battle at that point. As that pitch misses.
Yeah, so Christine, the plan is to switch after the bottom of the third right now. Okay. So 5-1. Now
the 1-2, way inside, bounce to first, easy play for Stover. Runner will advance to third, but now there's two outs.
Yeah. Just a routine play, but sometimes those are difficult.
That's the type of play that in the big leagues you see bats broken on
right.
With that wood because he really shanked it to the right side. And
are you old enough to know about Bill Buckner?
I am.
Yeah.
Fortunately, this isn't the World Series with millions of people watching.
No.
So if he did a Bill Buckner over there, no one would really.
Well, we would remind him of that. But.
So that'll bring up Mason Allen. He took a walk his first time up, and he takes this first pitch for a ball. He's seen five balls.
I think I was looking on Wikipedia. Bill Buckner's from Vallejo.
He is.
See, wow.
Here's the set. 1-0 pitch. Just high. Wow, where was that? All right, well, that's 2-0. Oh, okay. I mean, really looked like a strike. And time is called. Several occasions so far we've seen Jacksonberry have his hitter call time while he was out there because he's taking too long. He's really in no rush today.
No.
Because I have seen the Falcons quick pitch sometimes as there's a pitch outside. And you really got to like the fact that Berry's being careful with all his pitches today. Dangerous situation here, though. There's a runner on third, two outs, and it's a 3-0 count with Nick Schumacher on deck.
Well, I didn't think about that. So, you know, sometimes you might want to put a base runner on, but maybe not in this case.
Definitely not in this case. That pitch right down the heart of the plate for a strike. Berry really needed one. 3-1. Allen digs back in. And the 3-1. Swung on it, popped up, way up, back out of play. 3-2 now.
Yeah, into the new housing development.
Another good job by Jacksonberry. We've seen several times this game he gets behind 2-0 or 3-0 and winds up getting back to a two-strike count. Rather than just walking the batter or, you know, losing the at-bat.
Big pitch right here.
Here's the set. And the 3-2. Low. Misses low, and now Nick Schumacher's going to have two runners on base with two outs. Mason Allen's really got a good eye. That's his second walk in two at-bats.
First baseman, Nick Schumacher.
Like I mentioned earlier, 19 runs batted in 18 games and four home runs, which...
We don't want to see one now.
Yeah, and at this level, community college, you rarely see that many homers. He's got more home runs than the entire Falcons team combined. In fact, he's got more than double. Berry with the set. First pitch. Outside. Big at bat here. It's really tough to handle this, like decide how you're going to handle a situation like this. If you attack him, you might get him, but he might burn you. But if you were to, you know, walk him, that could work if you get Kale Leach. But if you don't get Kale Leach, now you have the bases loaded and multiple runs.
Yeah.
A big inning could start.
That's tricky. No, I mean, we'll see what he does on this pitch here.
That one's low again, 2-0. They haven't really come at him yet in this at-bat.
Might be one of those unintentional, intentional walks.
Yeah, that's probably the way I would go in this situation, but it's really hard to say that right now.
We'll know on this pitch.
Here comes the 2-0, and he swung on it and chopped at a pitch way out of the strike zone. Easy play for Jacksonberry. Jacksonberry gets Schumacher in a big situation. That is the end of the top of the third. Falcons keep their lead 1-0. Now we'll send it over to Melanie Fuller.
Good afternoon, Falcon fans. Melanie Fuller here. It is finally a beautiful sunny day out here in Fairfield, California. Just in case you missed it, last week we covered the baseball game against Yuba College. We also uploaded a new edition of our Solano College Sports Update, where you can watch an exclusive interview with Tim Moore. Be sure to check it out on our YouTube page at youtube.com/ Solano College Sports Network. Thank you. Now back to the inning intermission.
Hi, I'm Neil Glines, the Dean of the School of Liberal Arts, and I want to thank you for watching Solano College Sports Network.
And we're back, bottom of the third inning here. Really surprising end to that top of the inning. Nick Schumacher, you got to think a hitter like that, he really wanted to hit in that situation. He knows what's at stake. But with that being said, he just could not hold back. They were really pitching around him. Like they were, that was going to be ball three. They were going low the whole time.
That was a dream come true. That's got to be the shortest hit he's made all season.
He knew. He put his head down as soon as he swung at that. He tried to pull it back. It was a check swing chopper right to the mound. Great ending for the Falcons, though. As here's a bunt from Garland Webster down the third base line. And there's going to be no play. Cale Leach was unable to pull the ball out of his glove and make the throw.
Yeah, he almost ran from third base to first base.
Yeah, he ran a long way. He made a nice pickup of it, and he just couldn't pull it out of his glove. So there's a bunt single for Garland Webster. As you see the replay, he pulled it out, and something happened as he tried to throw it. It just didn't go for him. I guess he didn't have the right grip on the ball or whatever. He wasn't able to make the throw, but that'll bring up Evan Facenda, grounded out to short his first time up in the first inning. And he shows bunt, and he drops one down right in front of the mound. Great bunt. Throw to first will get him. But a great bunt there by Evan Facenda. He nearly beat it out himself. Yeah. Mason Allen makes the play for Folsom Lake.
Now batting. Right fielder, number 14.
That'll bring up Jesse Phipps. He had a bunt attempt in that first inning with no one on one out. He tried to bunt for a single, and he grounded out to short with the bunt. Runner on second, one out here. Good chance for Phipps.
They must have watched tape, and clearly they thought they could bunt for hits.
Well, and like I said earlier, they are top 10 in the state in sacrifice flies and sacrifice bunts.
Yeah, but some of them are actually bunting for hits. I mean, the last one was a sacrifice, but
they really like that game. They have some speedy players. They like to bunt a lot.
Yeah.
And with that being said, though, this is the most I've seen them bunt in such a short span. It's only been 2 1/3 innings.
Yeah.
Vlasic stepped off the mound. He steps back on. And he'll set. And the pitch to Phipps. Swung on and chopped. Back up the middle, got there at second by Harbor. He'll throw it to first, and that's a ground out, but he moves the runner up to third now for Joey Dodson.
Yeah. And any hit will score a run here.
Second baseman, number 3, Joey Dodson.
Joey Dodson singled his first time up, but he's looking for a little redemption because he did end the first inning by getting picked off after that single. He was looking to run, and you know, it's a lot harder to run on lefties than it is righties because their back is not turned to you. They can look straight at you, and they can start their pitching motion with their eyes looking directly at you. It's really hard to read. As there's a swing and a foul ball right side, that'll drop.
Also, in fairness, so Dodson also did make that nice double play, though.
Oh, yeah, he's more than redeemed himself by now. It's really hard, like I said, to try and make a steal off a lefty, and, yeah, he made a heck of a play out in the field. 0-1. Vlasic with the set. And the 0-1. Swung on a shot to second. Diving attempt, but Harbor can't come up with it. That's a base hit RBI for Dodson.
That's a big hit. He's 2 for 2 on the day.
As you see it on replay.
Yeah, just got through.
A really good effort by Harbor. He did everything he could. It even touched his glove, but he couldn't quite hold on to it. Briar Litz, 1 for 1. Base hit in the second inning to lead it off with a liner. One on, two out. Falcons up 2-0 now in the third. The set from Vlasic. Swung on and bounced to third, and it's dropped. It goes to the shortstop.
Wow.
And the throw gets away. Litz is going to head to second. Around third is Dodson. He'll hold up. And wow, what an odd play that was. It was a bouncer to third. Seemed like a routine play. Kale Leach missed it, but Litz isn't the fastest runner, and Joseph Smith still had a chance to throw him out, and he threw it away.
That's what I find amazing, is the physics. The it seemed like he didn't have a chance, but if it was a good throw, he would have got him. I mean,
Yeah, Joseph Smith was right behind Leach to back him up.
Yeah.
And so even though Leach missed the ball never stopped rolling. It would have been an easy out for them.
Exactly. I thought there was no chance once the guy was tipped, but...
I mean, honestly, you could give an error to both Leach and Smith on that play because Leach simply misplayed it, but Smith threw it away. But regardless, that's going to put a much bigger situation for the Falcons than originally. We have now second and third.
Yeah, they can really open this game up.
Yeah, already up two. They have a chance to go up four on a single from Luke Noble. Noble sack bunt. His first time up moved Litz over to second after Litz's single in the second inning. And this is also great for, even if they don't score any more runs here, it's great for Jackson Berry to see his team going and hitting. There's a shot deep to left.
Nice.
That's going to drop off the wall. One run's going to score. Holding up at second is Luke Noble with a double. Actually, it's going to score two runs.
That was a clutch hit.
A long line drive from Luke Noble.
Yeah, how close did the...
As you see it there, dropping on the warning track and going to the wall. Great job for Luke Noble. It's 4-0 now, and like I was saying just a second ago, Jackson Berry's got to feel really good right now. He's sitting down watching his team go and give him a big lead.
Yeah, nothing makes a pitcher happier than a two-out hit.
It takes a lot of the stress away from the pitcher, too. You know, you're pitching a 0-0 game. There's a little bit of stress there, but you're pitching a 4-0. You can relax when guys get on base. That'll bring up Stover. He takes a pitch outside 1-0. Stover with an RBI single, his first time up to open up the scoring. Vlasic with the set. And the 1-0. Right down the middle. 1-1. Good breaking ball. Vlasic with the set. And that's just on the bottom part of the strike zone. 1-2. Vlasic with the set. 1-2 pitch. Swung on, chopped off of his own foot. Two and two now on Stover. Vlasic finally with the set. And the pitch swung on and fouled back. Right side, 2-2. Still. Vlasic again with the set. And here comes the second 2-2 pitch. Swung on and chopped off of his foot again. So we'll do it over.
Yeah,
Vlasic with the set. The third 2-2 pitch swung on and fouled back again. This is a real battle right here between Vlasic and Stover.
What do the people that buy these new homes know that they're going to get foul balls in their backyard?
Vlasic again with the set. The fourth 2-2 pitch of the at-bat is swung on and
mile
popped
high,
up.
Mile high.
Way up. Smith's going to call it off.
Got it.
And Joseph Smith makes the routine catch. Stover gets his back shoulder a little low on that one. But nonetheless, great inning for the Falcons. They scored three
inning.
Runs. They take a 4-0 lead headed to the fourth inning.
My name is Joey Dotson, and thanks for watching the Solano College Sports Network.
Luke Noble, and thanks for watching the Solano College Sports Network.
And we're back. Fourth inning of play here in Solano. Jackson Berry back on the mound in quite a rhythm. He'll face Leach, Vaughn, and Pedretti. 5-6-7 hitters for the Folsom Lake Falcons. First pitch to Leach was low, 1-0. And the 1-0. Swung on and missed. Nice pitch. Handcuffed Leach. We've seen several times now he handcuffed a hitter getting it inside. So it's 1-1 now. The 1-1. Way inside. Handcuffed him again. Leach cannot lay off the pitch inside. He did strike out on a pitch just like that in the first inning as well.
Those are wicked pitches.
Now the 1-2. Just outside and low as well. 2-2. You know it's a good sign when you have a hitter who his last at bat was in the first inning and we're in the fourth inning.
Yeah, it also makes it easier on you. It's not like those other games we did where you had the team hitting around.
Inside corner, strike three. He got him. What a pitch from Jackson Berry. Strikeout number three today.
Let's check out the.
Now batting. Left fielder, Greg Vaughn.
Yeah.
You see the replay right there?
Yeah, looking.
That'll bring up Greg Vaughn, the left fielder. First hit of the game for Folsom Lake came off of his bat in the second inning. It's also the only hit they've had this game. They've been on base, though, several times with one reaching on an error and three walks. They've been on base five times with just one hit.
The key, though, is just the one hit.
And that pitch, low. 2-0. Barry, much quicker this inning with his pitches. He hasn't been holding up a whole lot. As there's a pitch swung on and popped up. Shallow right field.
Yeah.
Oh, diving play by Joey Dotson. He's just unable to come up with it. That was very, very high up there, and Phipps and Noble were just not close enough to make a play on it.
No man's land.
A bloop single for Greg Vaughn. Just a bit unlucky for Jackson Berry.
Now batting the DH.
And now Berry's going to start taking his time with his pitches once again, as you've seen every time he's pitched out of the stretch as opposed to the windup. So that'll bring up Pedretti. Grounded into a force out to third his last time up. And the pitch swung on the line right at second. It's caught. Throw to first. That's a double play.
Wow.
Line drive right to Joey Dodson and an easy end to the inning for Jackson Berry. You see the replay. He almost dropped it for a second there.
Yeah.
But an easy double play and another great inning for Jackson Berry. So that's four innings of shutout baseball for Berry. We'll be back with the bottom of the fourth after this. 4-0 Falcons. Welcome back. Bottom of the fourth inning. Falcons look to add to their lead, which is four right now. Great pitching from Jackson Berry.
And also excellent defense. Joey Dodson made another double play. And, I mean, the ball was right at him. He almost had to make it just to save his life. But he might be, it's either the positioning. He knows where to be on those defensive positioning.
Yeah, Dodson's really made two double plays off of two balls that were just scorched right at him. And showing no fear, he's been able to make those two plays. As there's a swing and a line drive. Diving stop by Smith at short. Gets up and throws on the spin. What a play by Joseph Smith.
That's like an all-star play out there.
Yeah, Pridey really put a charge. I'm sorry, Quintanilla really put a charge on the ball, but a heck of a play.
Yeah.
Or no, it was Pridey. But yeah, you see the replay there. Heck of a play by Smith, man. So that'll bring up JoJo Quintanilla. He shows bunt, pulls it back outside. 1-0. And the pitch from Vlasic. Now he gets the bunt down, but it's foul.
That's what I'm talking about, bunting for hits.
The Falcons really using the bunt as much as they can today. So Quintanilla digs back in, down in the count. Swing and a miss. That's two strikes. Got Garland Webster on deck here. He singled his first time up with a bunt. Quintanilla no longer showing bunt after two strikes down on him. He swings and fouls that one back. Stays alive in the count. He grounded into a force out his first time up in the second inning there. Vlasic with the set, the pitch, and he swings and bounces one to second. Charlie Harbor over there with it. He'll make the throw to first, and that's two up, two down in the fourth inning.
Yeah, this game has gone relatively fast. They must know about your 5 p.m. curfew. Tell people what's going on. If you're people don't know that you're a very good hockey player in California, and you got teams back east looking at you.
Yeah, well, I have another call today with a coach from Shelburne, Ontario, so I have to leave at 5 o'clock, and Professor Poff is going to fill in for me alongside you at the end of this game.
Yeah, well, I kind of want to do that. We'll see. We'll see if we have the opportunity. The game will have to stretch. But next thing, we'll talk a little more about hockey in California.
The pitch to Webster fouled back. Webster, as I mentioned a second ago, reached bunt single his first time up. There's a pitch low. Good eye.
Unless you've fooled me with, like, dental work, will you be the only guy in that league with a full set of teeth?
No, everyone that plays, you know, youth hockey has to wear a cage. So this will be my first time wearing the visor where I could actually have my teeth knocked out.
So that's what you have to look forward to.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to losing a few teeth.
Yeah. No, seriously, pretty much anybody that's come from Canada, they don't have their teeth.
There's a walk. The pitch low. Yeah, you're right. I've seen quite a few players in my day with some missing teeth. But most of them aren't my age right now. We're not really able to have that happen yet. But next year, you know, I might come back for a game. And, you know, I might have a little lisp with three teeth missing. Never know. Evan Facenda back up.
With the whatever the cage, it protects you, but you can't see as much. Why won't they wear a cage like when you're older?
You know, they don't wear a cage for the most part, I think, because it just doesn't look as cool to them. But it really is the best way to protect your face. And all the college teams wear it, too.
Okay.
Yeah. The only place that they don't wear it is – and there's no place you can go where you're not allowed to wear it. It's just, for the most part, at juniors and in the pros, they just don't wear it. There's a swing and a shot to right. That's going to drop in a base hit. Good solid swing from Evan Facenda. And that'll put two runners on with two outs. Two-out rally for the Falcons.
Yeah, we saw what happened last day. The two-out double.
Yeah, they got all three of their runs with two outs last inning. And they got their first run with one out in the second inning. So they haven't necessarily started out inning scoring runs, but they've had some clutch hits today. Jesse Phipps is up. 0-for-2. He bunt grounded to third, and he also grounded to second. Vlasic with the set.
Some activity in the Folsom's bullpen. Number 17 just got up.
Here's a swing and a shot to right. This is deep. Going back off the wall. That's going to score one. That's going to score two. Phipps on his way to second and a hold up with a two-run double. 6-0 Solano.
Another two-out hit. Pretty much the whole team is out here to greet him, as they should.
The Falcons are absolutely pumped right now. And Dotson's going to go over to talk to Stover because Folsom's manager is going to come out now. They just sent 17 to the bullpen, so he's got to be stalling. There's no way that they can make the change at this point. He's only thrown a few warm-up pitches. That would be Craig Stafford, number 17, in the bullpen.
That's number 17?
Yeah, Craig Stafford. All right, well, this inning's far from over for the Falcons with Joey Dodson coming up.
Yep.
They got the 3-4-5 hitters.
Not batting.
And you got a runner on second with two outs. Definitely an opportunity for some runs. Dodson drove in a run his first time up with an RBI single. He's got two singles today. And he's also turned two double plays. So he's really turning in a strong candidate for player of the game.
Yeah.
The set, the pitch, swung on a shot to left. That's going to knock in another run. Base hit to the left center gap. He's going to head to second and get there standing up. Wow. RBI double. Dodson's 3-for-3.
And another two-out hit.
And it's 7-0. Solano has really opened up this game now. That'll bring up Briar Litz.
Catcher, number
30. Litz has been on base both times today. He has a single and he reached on that throwing error last inning that helped open up the game with Noble winding up with a two-run single to make it 4-0. First pitch to Litz is low and outside, 1-0. And the 1-0. Low, 2-0. And now Mason Allen's going to go talk to Vlasic. Probably just try to settle him down a little bit here before this game gets too out of hand. Vlasic with the set. Pitch. The bunt pulled back by Litz. That pitch was inside. And the pitch. Inside. Wow. That one missed just barely. Another good eye from Briar Litz. He's got a 3-1 count.
Yeah. He's making the most of his start today.
This could be his third trip to the base paths in 3 at-bats. And a swing and a pop-up. Foul down the right side. Full count. Now the set, here's a 3-2 pitch. Swung on a bounce back up the middle. Getting over there is Smith, and he'll make the play with ease. That ends the fourth. Fifth inning of play now. Jackson Berry looking to keep that shutout going.
Charlie Harbor.
4 great innings so far, and he has a 7-0 lead as Charlie Harbor, Michael Majeski, and Joseph Smith, the 8-9-1 hitters coming up for Folsom Lake. First pitch is outside, 1-0. Now the set, the 1-0. And that's low. Oh. Took a short hop and then knocked off the mask of Briar Litz.
You got to be tough to be a catcher.
Yeah, we were talking earlier about, you know, goalies and catchers, man. It's not an easy job.
No.
2-0 pitch. Missed again. 3-0.
Yeah. No.
And the 3-0 pitch. That's in there. Strike one. 3-1. And the 3-1. Swung on and shot right up the middle. That's going to be a base hit. Solid line drive single for Charlie Harbor, the third hit of the game for Folsom Lake.
Now batting, center fielder, Michael Majeski.
So that'll bring up Michael Majeski. He took a walk his first time up back in the third inning. Number 9 hitter for Folsom Lake. And the set, first pitch is in there for a strike. Litz took a bluff at Harbor like he would throw it over there. They obviously consider Harbor a running threat.
Oh, she found out last game, all these runners are threats.
And the 0-1, and they show bunt, pulls it back, 1-1.
I'm not sure they should be bunting. They're down by 7 runs.
That might be part of the reason, too, though, with no one out. They're just trying to get a runner in scoring position.
I guess so. Get that first run.
They haven't had runners in scoring position since that first inning when they got to second and third on the error. It was a swing and a foul back. Berry with the set. And the pitch. Swung on and fouled back again. Majeski's just trying to stay alive in this at bat. In the pitch, swung on and missed, struck him out. Another great breaking ball from Jackson Berry. That's strikeout number 4 on the night, or on the day.
Yeah.
He gets Majeski. What was that?
No, I was going to say it's all semantics. It's the same thing.
Shortstop, Joseph Smith.
But technically it is daytime right now.
Well, Joseph Smith struck out in a sack bunt. He hasn't had any luck at the plate today, but we've seen him make some flashy plays in the field.
Yeah.
First pitch to Smith. Outside corner, strike one. Now the 0-1, swung on and popped up foul, 0-2. The Folsom Lake lineup, they're 6th in the state in walks earned. They have great eyes. You know, they hit a lot of home runs. They drive in a lot of runs. And Jackson Berry has found a way to make sure he's limiting the at-bats of each one of these players. He's pitching ahead.
Yeah.
And he's really not led anyone in scoring position other than that one error in the first inning.
Yeah, it seems like a lifetime ago. And then after that, I mean, you can't say enough about our hitting, the Solano hitting, to have those two-out hits. I mean, those it's been huge.
That pitch was outside on Smith. But, yeah, I mean, it's really the key to facing a good lineup like this. If you limit your mistake pitches, and then, you know, to a certain extent, you almost hope that they just have a bad day as well. But especially some of the really big guys like Nick Schumacher. The less at-bats, as he got him called strike 3. Wow. That one looked inside to me, but
yeah.
We'll take it. 5 strikeouts on the day for Berry. He gets Smith looking. And that'll bring up Kame. But, yeah, with a guy like Schumacher or Leach or Allen, the less you have to see of them, the less risk you have of, you know, being another one of those home run statistics.
That was also huge. But when Schumacher, was that the first inning? When was that? That he was on and had that dribbler.
The third inning.
Yeah, that was also, that was
Well, that was a huge situation. He faced their best hitter with runners on first and third and got out of it with no damage. Swinging a high fly ball to right. Phipps is going to come over. It's going to head into foul territory and drop. Phipps was just unable to get over there in time.
He was surrounded by Folsom Lake players in the bullpen.
So that's strike one on Tyler Kame.
And we're gonna go to McKinney. Okay. No, sir. Okay.
Now the set from Barry. And the 0-1. Just missed. Briar Litz did his best frame job on that one, but unable to make the play or make it a strike. Now the set from Barry and the pitch. Swung on and fouled right back again. Two strikes on Kame. And the 1-2, swung on a rope right to center. That's going to drop in, base hit. Line drive single for Tyler Kame. And now, for the first time in a while here, they have two runners on base. First time since the third inning, in fact. That'll bring up Mason Allen. Allen has one heck of an eye. He's taken two walks. The first one was on four straight pitches, all of which were really close to the strike zone. And then the second time they worked a full count and a much longer at bat, he worked another walk. He's a very patient hitter.
Yeah, very patient man.
Two on, two out. Big situation here with Schumacher on deck again. Last time that they had Schumacher on deck in the big situation and they walked Allen to get to Schumacher. Obviously not intentionally, but they were able to retire Schumacher. I wouldn't want to have to face him with the bases loaded in this situation, though.
No, I think we got our get-out-of-jail-free card last time when he had that little dribbler.
Yeah, definitely not a pitch you would expect a guy like that to swing on. It was well low, but they really got fortunate on that play. There's a swing and a foul back. Allen barely touched a piece of that. Now the set from Barry. And the pitch is in there, outside corner for a strike. Nice pitch from Jackson Barry. That's two strikes. So Barry again ahead in the count, 1-2. Barry gets the sign. And the 1-2. Swung on a bounce right back to Barry. It goes off of his glove. Coming in to try and barehand it was Garland Webster, and he nearly did, but it gets behind him. Just a little unfortunate there. Barry nearly made the play, and Webster nearly covered him with that play. Now you have a really bad situation. Nick Schumacher is going to come up with the bases loaded.
I go for a hit.
So Schumacher reached on an error in the first, grounded out in the third. You mentioned that gift.
Yeah. Well, I'm thinking right now this is maybe they're doing this for our ratings. Bases loaded with the best hitter up.
Now you can attack him or you could you know, almost pitch around and be willing to maybe sacrifice a run
yeah.
to avoid the possibility of a grand slam when you have a hitter like this who hits so many home runs. But with a 7-0 lead, you feel like you have enough of a padding to go right after him.
Yeah.
As there's a pitch outside. That's what I would do. I would go right after him. You got him last time. Yeah. You know, you got him last time. That's definitely in his head. He definitely feels like he wants to make good this time. So you could probably get him to chase a couple pitches. Here's the 1-0. Swung on a pop straight up. This might get out of play. Litz is over there, and it will get out of play.
By about 10 feet.
1-1. And that's a little bit unfortunate that it got out of play. If that had come just 10 feet closer, they could have had another free out on Schumacher. Nonetheless, got him to pop it up. 1-1 count. And the 1-1 pitch. And it hit him. It came inside a little too far.
Actually, you know what he's saying? He's setting him back.
He's going to go. Well, what is he calling? That definitely looked like it hit Schumacher on the elbow from what I saw.
Okay. Yeah, no.
So he says he didn't try to get out of the way. Interesting call from the umpire, but we'll do it again, I guess. Schumacher's going to have to stay in the batter's box now, so fortunate break for the Falcons and his two strikes. And a swing and a pop-up again. Foul territory. I don't think this is going to stay in play. Stover's over there, and it won't. It'll just get out of play. Barry's doing a heck of a job on Schumacher so far this at-bat. Now the set. Big pitch for Barry. Swung on it. Bounced to short. Webster's up with it.
Wow.
He'll flip it to second to Dodson. That's an easy play. He gets Schumacher with the bases loaded this time after getting him with first and third last time. That'll end the top of the fifth inning. We'll be right back with the bottom of the fifth. Falcons still up 7-0.
Hi, I'm Jesse Phipps. Thanks for watching the Solano College Sports Network.
Bottom of the fifth inning now. Falcons up 7-0. They've added to their lead in the second, third, and fourth, so they look to keep up their streak of three straight innings with runs scored. Great ending to that last one, though. I mean, I know that the Falcons have been scoring a whole lot here, but I've really been focused on Jackson Berry's pitching performance right now. It's been masterful.
Particularly after the games we saw with all the runs that were given up. Used to run a shutout.
And yeah, I've never seen the Falcons pitching this well this season, at least. And, I mean, Jackson Berry's on top of his game right now.
And the the hitting. I mean, that the guy that got with the bases loaded. I mean, that was
No Schumacher. Slump. We mentioned at the start of the game how good of a hitter he is. He's got 19 RBIs in 18 games and 4 home runs, and they've gotten him with the runners on first and third and bases loaded, two outs, and both times Barry was able to win that battle. He won the battle the first time too, but Phipps wound up making the error, so he's really taking him down three times. As that pitch is on the inside corner for a strike, Luke Noble leading off the bottom of the fifth here. Noble, Stover, and Pridey. It's the 5-6-7 hitters for the Falcons. Noble hit that two-run double with two outs in the third inning that made the game 4-0 as there's a pitch low. He also has a sacrifice bunt, so he's been well at the plate today.
Oh, no. I'll get some effort.
So Tanner Clark, new pitcher for Folsom Lake this inning to face Luke Noble here. Tough day for Vlasic. This is a swing and a bouncer to second. Easy play there for Charlie Harbor.
Yeah.
Like a pickle, Vlasic got crunched. Yeah,
pretty much. But as we talked before, neither of us are crunching him. We don't eat pickles.
That's true. It wasn't us who was crunching him. It was the Falcons.
Tyler Stover.
Tyler Stover's up now. Hopefully going to give us some good baseball to watch so we can talk about, you know, stuff like that and not terrible jokes.
Clark, the new pitcher, didn't have to travel far. He goes to Folsom College. He went to Folsom High School.
That pitch is inside. Ball one. And the pitch, that's in there.
I always put you on the spot, but you're a math guy. What was the Folsom's pitcher's ERA today?
17.5.
Tell people how you figure that out. I mean, that's
well, he gave up 7 runs in 4 innings. So multiply that by 2, that's 14 runs in 8 innings. And then divide 7 in half, that's 3.5, so 17.5 in 9 innings.
You should teach a class.
All I can do is multiplication and division. I don't mess with that algebra stuff.
No, but you found. Yeah, what are imaginary numbers?
Oh. This is a pop-up caught by Charlie Harbor. 2 outs. Imaginary numbers?
That was something I remember studying.
I think I've heard of it. Yeah, I can't tell you.
Third baseman, number 11, Jack Pridey.
So Jack Pridey's up now. A bunt force out his first time up. He tried to get the sack bunt to move Stover to second, but alertly, Vlasic threw it to second to get the out. This is a line drive, left field line. That's going to get down. Pridey's rounding first. He's going to hold up with a base hit just past the outstretched glove of Cale Leach. Down the third base line. Nice swing from Jack Pridey. And the Falcons are in business again with 2 outs. 2 out hitting has been their forte today.
Yeah.
Now batting. Left fielder, number 28, JoJo Quintanilla.
That'll bring up JoJo Quintanilla. Grounded into a force out to second, and then he grounded out to second. So, two very similar at bats, his first two at bats. He's going to want to switch that up here. And the pitch is bounced, foul down the left side. And the set.
Let's wait after this batter.
And that's low. Now the set. And popped up again by Quintanilla. That's going to hit the pole. Foul ball. Quintanilla digs back in. 1-2. And the 1-2 pitch. Swung on it.
Wow.
Rolled right back up the middle. Past the diving Charlie Harbor into center. Heading from first all the way to third is Pridey. Solid base hit from Joseph Quintanilla. And the Falcons just keep on hitting with two outs.
You read my mind. As I say, another key two-out hit.
Now they need one more to get that run in. Garland Webster's going to come up. A bunt single and a walk. He's had two trips to the bases and two trips to the plate.
Yeah. Before the catcher's going out to talk to the new pitcher.
Allen's been out there at the mound several times today.
Yeah, should put a pedometer on him.
Allen gives the signs to the infield. Webster digs in. Clark taking a look at the runner at first now, and he gets the sign. And the pitch. Outside. Ball one. Now the set, 1-0. Oh, it's a throw to first. In fact, it was a 3-1 pickoff move. He faked it to third and then turned to first to make sure that the runner there was still on.
He's keeping everything covered.
They've actually
they had that one pickoff.
Outlawed that rule in the MLB now.
Oh, okay.
As that pitch is fouled off because I guess they think it's too much like a balk, maybe. You know, and it just slows the game down to keep having a guy faking to third, faking to first, and not actually throwing.
Is that new this year or last year?
Last year they put it in place. Okay. And the pitch. Webster swings and misses. Going down to second is Quintanilla with a delayed steal, and he's safe. Great job by Quintanilla. And that'll put runners on second and third now for Webster.
Yeah.
A single could put two more runs on the board for the Falcons. And the pitch bounces in. That's a ball. And the pitch.
Wow.
High.
Full count.
Full count, two on, two out. Bottom of the fifth. Big chance for the Falcons, but not necessarily a dire situation with their 7-0 lead. You never know how much a team could come back, so every chance you get, you want to add runs. As he swings and misses on a pitch low. Good pitch. Credit to Clark for that pitch, but Webster strikes out to end the fifth inning. Falcons remain on top 7-0.
Hi, I'm Jack Pridey. Thanks for watching the Solano College Sports Network.
Oh,
welcome back. Top of the sixth inning now. Folsom Lake desperately trying to get something going here against Jackson Berry, who has pitched five masterful innings so far, all shutout. Kale Leach will lead off. It's Leach, Vaughn, and Pedretti. First pitch outside, ball one. Leach only two at bats so far, because of the way Barry's been putting the hitters up and down. He struck him out on both of those at bats.
No, I mean, you're
2-0.
Your scorebook is so clean.
And the pitch. That's in there for a strike, 2-1. Yeah, you mentioned my scorebook. It looks a lot cleaner this time around,
yeah,
since people aren't batting multiple times in the same inning.
Makes it much easier for you.
Yeah, Berry with the pitch outside, 3-1 on Jackson Berry. He's had a few walks today. This could be his fourth if he throws a ball here, but when you combine that with the fact that he's got five strikeouts and no runs, as that pitch is fouled off, full count. Only five hits for Folsom Lake in this game. Through five innings, that's very impressive. There's a swing and a pop-up way up to left. Under it and making the catch is Quintanilla. Very high pop-up to left field. But that's one up and one down. That'll bring up Greg Vaughn, left fielder, number 10 for Folsom Lake.
Now batting, left fielder, Greg Vaughn.
Berry, first pitch to Vaughn, swung on and fouled back. And that pitch, breaking ball, cuts just too low. That's a ball. 2-0. And that pitch is low again, 3-0. And the 3-0 pitch. Chopped, foul on the third base side. Pridey was not able to get over there before it went foul. And the 3-1. That's swung on in line to second. It's going to drop. Shallow right center field. Looked for a second there like Dodson might have a chance, but it wound up being too far. Solid base hit for Greg Vaughn.
Now batting the DH, Joel Pedretti.
Joel Pedretti, the designated hitter, now up. He grounded into a force out over to third in the second inning, and then he lined into that double play that Dodson turned in the fourth. Line drive was hit right to him, and Greg Vaughn really didn't read it well. Greg Vaughn, number six hitter in the lineup, that's fouled off. He's got three of the Folsom Lake Falcons' six hits himself. He's 3-for-3 with three singles. And another interesting thing, a really important thing to note about Jackson Berry's performance today, is that all six of the hits against him are singles. He has not allowed an extra base hit. And we mentioned earlier, a team that has a lot of doubles. There's a runner heading to second. Throw down to second, not in time. Stolen base for Vaughn. First stolen base of the game for Folsom Lake. It's very important to limit those extra base hits, especially against a team like Folsom Lake, who has so many of those extra base hits. They have a lot of doubles. They have a few triples. They hit homers. And Berry is really, the hits he has allowed have been very short hits that, you know, aren't all that damaging.
And the key to getting the Schumacher out both times with runners on first and second and the bases loaded.
Nice stop by Briar Litz on that ball that bounced in. Kept it in front of him.
The other game we had so many pass balls and wild pitches. We haven't seen any of that today.
Yeah, not one. Barry steps off. Doesn't like the big lead Vaughn's trying to take. Here's the set. And the pitch is fouled off again by Pedretti. And there's a throw down to second. Easily back in there is Vaughn, his whole bench screaming back.
It's this connection. It needs to be nice to it. Harry, can you hear me?
Again, the set. And the pitch is swung on its chop to Stover. Stover will flip it to Barry, who came over to cover. Nice job by Jackson Barry.
Well, he had to be there because Stover couldn't have done it himself.
So that's a ground into a force for Pedretti.
Charlie Harbor.
A 3-1 on the put out there, very rare. Charlie Harbor will be up now. Runner on third, two outs. Every time that the Folsom Lake Falcons have had runners on third base, three times now that's happened. Every time it's been with two outs, and Barry's been able to be in a situation that's pretty manageable. Actually, three times now, and all with two outs.
Yeah.
He faced Leach and twice Schumacher, who are their 4 and 5 hitters. So he's faced the best hitters with the two-out situation. Now we have the number 8 hitter, Harbor, with two outs. And the pitch swung on and popped up.
Mile high.
And it's just going to drop. No real chance for Litz there.
No.
That one dropped rapidly.
Right in front of us.
Literally right in front of us. Harbor gets back in. He grounded into a double play. Second inning, he also has a single in the fifth. And the pitch swung on and missed. Nice pitch from Jackson Berry. He had Harbor fooled, and that's two strikes.
Yeah, good. Both, yeah, exactly. Good, thank you.
And the set, the two-strike pitch, swung on and fouled back again. Fighting to stay alive is Charlie Harbor.
I think Folsom Lake just wants to get on the board.
Nothing worse than being shut out in a long game like baseball.
Yeah, I'm trying to think what could be worse. Getting shut out in hockey?
I don't know. That happens a lot more often, I think, than baseball. Yeah. There's a swing and a bouncer back past the mound. Webster will get it at short. And he'll fire it to first. Another shutout inning for Jackson Berry. Six phenomenal innings. That's the end of the top of the sixth. We're going to send it over now to Melanie Fuller and McKenna.
Hey, guys. I'm McKenna Guerrero alongside my broadcast partner, Melanie Fuller. And this is the Solano College Sports Network. If you have an interest in the career in sports broadcasting, whether it be behind the scenes or in front of the camera, this is the class for you.
Classes are held every Wednesday from 1:30 to 4:30 in room 121 alongside the library building. For more information, contact Greg Poth at gpoth@solano.edu. We hope to see you there next semester. And remember, it's more than just sports. It's an education. We'll be right back.
Welcome back. Bottom of the sixth inning now. The Falcons, phenomenal pitching game so far, as well as a hitting game. They're up 7-0. It's going to be Webster, Facenda, Facenda, Phipps, and Dodson. And once again, today's game is brought to you by JamesThomasMedia.com, your stop for all your video production needs. Top of the lineup here, Evan Facenda is going to start us off. Facenda with a single, a sack bunt, and a ground out. And he drops a bunt down the third base line. It's going to go foul.
Oh, another trying to bunt for a hit.
Yeah, the Falcons have been bunting just about every inning for a while now. And Facenda himself dropped down a sack bunt in the third. And that pitch is apparently just a little high. That looked pretty good, but good eye for Facenda as he takes that one. Tough pitch to lay off. That pitch misses as well, low and outside.
We mentioned, you're up against the clock here. You personally, this might be one of your last innings. We're talking about the hockey. You mentioned how they're going to be calling you. Will you be in school or will it be just playing hockey?
Well, I could take, and I probably would take, as that's fouled off, a few community college classes. So it'd be like playing at this level for Solano College, but in the hockey region.
Right.
It's like a junior college type of thing. I'm going to take 2 years, probably one or two, to try and get a college scholarship guys are doing.
So yeah, but it'll be independent. You won't be at a school. It'll be on a team. You'll be
right. Yeah. So I may be taking a class or two. As there's a swing and a line drive right center field, that's going to drop. It's going to head to the wall. Facenda's going to have a double, and another hit for the Falcons. Nice job by Evan Facenda. Yeah, I'll be taking probably a small amount of classes,
right.
Like a class or two, maybe. Online or maybe, at a community college nearby.
But what will the goal to be enter college as a freshman or enter college as a junior?
Well, I mean, yeah, I think that the classes kind of like start over once you get to the NCAA. So for athletic eligibility, I'll have 4 years of eligibility.
That's what I'm saying. You'll have 4 years.
Yes.
Of that. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Community college doesn't count against that. But as a student, I'll have been taking college classes for 5 years.
Because people don't know. You're a high school senior right now.
Yeah, I am. And I've been taking classes here since I was a sophomore, as that's fouled off. So, yeah, I'll really feel like I've been in college for forever point.
You'll be like a doctor.
Yeah, I mean, when I graduate, it'll be 9 years of college classes.
You might be one of the smartest hockey players ever.
I don't know about that. Then again, it's not too hard to be a really smart hockey player.
Exactly. Yeah.
Phipps now.
The other thing we should touch on is what your team here in California did.
There's a swing and a line drive right center. That's going to drop. Facenda's going to hold up at third. He really got a slow read on that. If he had gotten a good jump, he probably would have scored, and I think that's what Stover's telling him.
I don't know, but he had to make – I'll start with Stover. I thought maybe he thought there was going to be caught, but Stover's, I guess, saying you could tell it was going to drop.
I mean, he definitely should have hesitated at first, but, it was pretty quickly into that I felt like it was going to drop for a hit, so he probably could have got a quicker read on it. But first and third, nobody out for Dodson. And what were you saying before that?
Oh, I was talking about hockey, but I wanted to mention, is it possible for Solano to score without two outs, though?
I mean, we haven't seen it this game, so I don't know. I would hope so. We'll see right now. But, yeah, what my team did, you said.
Oh, yeah, exactly. No, talk about this, what your team did.
Yeah, so this Sunday my hockey team won the California State Championship for
actually, we should mention
our age group.
There's some sort of a caucus going on here.
Stover has something he is upset about, and he wants to tell the umpire. He did make a point over to the left side. Not sure if there's something to do with the third baseman, Leach.
And the Folsom Manders going out there.
Yeah, it's something to do with Kale Leach here.
Maybe Leach broke one of the unspoken rules of baseball or something.
He goes over there and just shook Stover's hand, apparently apologizing for whatever happened.
He must have said something or done something. Or.
Well, whatever it is, it's resolved now. So Dodson will get his chance to hit. Dodson 3-for-3. He's got a single, an RBI single, and an RBI double.
And two double plays. The good
and
double
yeah,
plays.
Yeah, the defense he has also turned in very well. As there's the set, pitch is high, outside, 1-0.
Situation permitting, we'll try. So, yeah, tell people what your California hockey team is.
Well, we won the state championship on Sunday. As this pitch is lined into right, that's a base hit. Another run will score. And, well, there's your question. It's possible to score with not two outs.
Yeah.
So
I didn't think it was possible.
Joey Dodson, 4-for-4 with three runs batted in. What a heck of a game he's playing right now. But anyway, as you see the replay here at that line drive, he just shoots it inside out swing to the other side. That'll bring up Briar Litz, two on, no out.
But your California team is headed to Buffalo.
Yes, we're heading to Buffalo, New York to represent California in the Nationals National Championships on March 31st till April 4th.
Are they series or just one game?
Is a little number to first, easy out, but Litz does advance both runners, so second and third and only one out now. What happens is there's several different divisions with a set number of teams in them. I believe it's 8 divisions of 4 teams.
Well, it's like almost like pool play. You qualify.
Yes, yeah. You will play 3 games of pool play, the 8 divisions of 4 teams, so you play the other 3 teams in your division in 3 games. And then the best team out of those 4 in each division goes on to the quarterfinals, all 8 teams.
Yeah.
And then there's a semifinal and a championship. So if you wind up making it all the way to the championship, that's 6 games played.
Wow. And they probably also have a loser's bracket too, I would think. Or maybe not.
I don't believe so.
Okay.
I believe it's just if you don't do well enough, your 3 games, it's over.
You go home.
Yeah. So that'll bring up Luke Noble, 2-run double in the 3rd inning. He grounded out. He's had a sack bunt. Everyone seems to have gotten in on this parade of runs for the Falcons today. And there's a swing and a bouncer back up the middle. This might get through. It's not. Harbor gets it, throws it to first for an out, but that's an RBI. RBI for Luke Noble. And the Falcons take a 9-0 lead now. So Tyler Stover will come up now with a runner on third, 2 outs. A chance to put the Falcons into double digits here as they lead 9-0. It's been a great game for them today. Folsom comes into this at 5-1 in conference in the BVC. So a 10-8 team overall. They're not a bad team at all. They're having a much better season than the Falcons were win-loss-wise. This is a really good win for the Falcons if they can hold on to this big lead.
You can't call this a win yet.
Yeah, if they can hold on to this big lead,
then
this would be a phenomenal win for them. As that pitch, wow, what a stop by Mason Allen right there.
Absolutely. It would put the Solano above 500. It would be a 3-2 in conference.
And And Clark with the pitch. Swung on and high chopped over to Leach at third. Leach will make the throw over to first. Stover is out. And that ends the sixth inning. The Falcons extend their lead now 9-0 over Folsom Lake. We'll be right back.
Evan Facenda, thank you for watching the Solano College Sports Network.
All right, we're back. Seventh inning of play now. Jackson Berry had a phenomenal six innings. His night is done. He will leave the game with a six-inning shutout, and hopefully he's going to get a win here. The only way he can't is if Folsom Lake winds up with 9 runs in the last 3 innings. The new pitcher is Jordan Chana. Chana has only pitched in 2 2/3 innings this season. Surrendered 4 earned runs in that time, a 1350 ERA.
A freshman pitcher from Clear Lake High School.
23, Jordan Chana.
And that first pitch fouled off to the right side by Majeski. Michael Majeski will lead it off. It's the 9-1-2 hitters for Folsom Lake. Majeski, Smith, and Kame. And the 0-1 delivery swung on and missed. 0-2 on Majeski. And the set. 0-2 from Shauna, outside, 1-2. And there's a swing and a fly ball, right side, very foul, still 1-2. Shauna sets, and he got him. Strike three. Nice pitch from Shauna, and a good start to his outing. He starts it the same way Jackson Berry did, right, with a strikeout.
I'm going to test you with that sound they played. Do you know what video game that's from?
Joseph Smith.
Galaga?
Yep, good guess. Pac-Man. I'm impressed, though, that you know about Galaga.
I only know because my grandpa had some really old games back in the day.
He had a Galaga at the house?
He did.
Man, I wish I knew your grandpa.
There's a pitch low.
Tell the young people the key to the Galaga.
The key is to press the trigger a lot of times,
but also
and move it back and forth.
But you also want to get the two ships.
Oh, you mean the key to winning?
Yes.
I meant just the key to staying alive.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to get it. It takes forever. There's so many different levels. You have to, like, kill so many of those things and not get your fighter captured and all that.
Well, no, you know, you want to get the fighter captured and then get it. That's how you become the
Oh, that's right. There's a pitch inside.
So what else did he have besides Galaga?
Oh, he had Galaga, Pac-Man, and like a whole set of games like that. Really old games. I don't even know what you would call the console that they were playing that on. That's fouled off. It had some kind of stick. Shauna with the set. And another foul back by Smith. Trying to stay alive. He wants to get on base here. He really hasn't been on base at all today. He had a sack bunt, and he struck out twice.
Yeah, but he did have that one great defensive play.
He's had more than one. He's made a few. But, yeah, there was one in particular with the dive and then the spinning throw.
That'd be like
phenomenal play.
Put that on the highlight reel.
But he's going to sit down for the third time today due to a strikeout. Shauna has come out and two quick strikeouts right here. Tyler Kames coming up at a great start to the game in relief of Jackson Berry, who is pitching very well himself.
Now batting right fielder, Tyler Kames.
Kames with two ground outs and a single. And a swing and a bouncer to second. Easy play for Joey Dotson. Three up, three down. Michael Shauna with a very easy inning in relief. And that'll end the top of the seventh inning. We're heading to the seventh inning stretch. Falcons up 9-0.
Hi, my name is Garland Webster, and thank you for watching the Solano College Sports Network.
Broadcasting substitution.
Yeah.
Tristan Vector, what, went seven innings of work, has got to get to hockey practice. I'm Greg Poff. I'll be taking over. And pretty good game for the Solano Falcons. And you talk about this three-game stretch. Laney on the road, Folsom Lake here, Laney tomorrow. This bodes well for the Falcons. They get another win tomorrow.
Yeah, conference.
Let's not call this one yet.
No.
But it's looking good. That'd be a nice little stretch for the Falcons.
Right, I'm thinking in terms of the rules. Who will you get credit for the win today, or does Tristan?
Tristan gets credit because he went five,
right? That's
right.
We went five. Correct.
I'll get the save.
You can get the save. Yeah.
Bottom of the seventh for Solano.
All right. Well, we go to the bottom of the seventh inning for the Solano Falcons. Leading things off will be Jack Pridey. He'll be followed by JoJo Quintanilla, and then Garland Webster. Any of those three get on board, we go back to the top of the inning and Evan Facenda. And the first pitch, Pridey takes low for a ball. On the mound, number 17, Craig Stafford, right-handed pitcher. Went to Folsom High School.
Didn't have to travel too far.
Pitching out of the stretch and the pitch. Pridey lifts this one, but it's going to go way out of play, foul. Really got under that one, left side, left field side of play. So, Brian, what's impressed you about the Falcons today?
Well, it was the starting pitcher. I mean,
Jackson incredible. Berry.
Yeah, exactly. No, I mean, to go five, six innings of shutout, and then to get their best hitter twice with runners on first and second, and
Pride pops that one up. First baseman settles under it and makes the catch. That'll be the first out here in the bottom of the seventh. Now coming up to the plate, number 28, JoJo Quintanilla, the left fielder for the Falcons.
And also the two-out hitting. And Joey Dotson at second base, the hitting and the double plays, the good type, the defensive double plays.
So there you get a good look at JoJo Quintanilla, 1-for-3 today, has a single and a stolen base. First pitch by Stafford, high and away for a ball. So different lineup today for the Falcons.
Yes.
Looks like that is working out quite well.
Yeah, maybe, yeah. I don't know if he seems like he almost pulled it out of a hat, you know. But
oh, I doubt that.
No, okay. Yeah, no, okay. But it did. He did mix it up in a big way. And
good eye by Quintanilla. Takes that one inside for a ball.
Went to come up with 9 runs.
Not too shabby. Inside again. So that's going to be 3 balls, no strikes. One out here, bottom of the seventh. We hope you're enjoying our game here on the Solano College Sports Network. Falcons leading handily, 9-0. Stafford set, and the pitch, and it hits JoJo.
Yeah.
So he was getting on either way.
Yeah.
He probably would prefer it, just would have missed a little bit,
exactly.
Get the walk, but
yeah.
Well, hit by pitch, he'll trot down to first base.
He chose the more painful, he didn't choose it, but I meant the... We're back in business,
boys. So coming up to the plate, Garland Webster, the shortstop for the Falcons. Had a bunt single back in the third, walked in the fourth, and grounded out in the fifth. If I'm reading Tristan's scoreboard, I'm not sure what a 6-6 is.
Yeah, that'd be a tough play.
And that one's ripped just to the shortstop. Nice glove. Gets to the second. Over to first. Double play by the Falcons. So 3 up, 3 down for the Falcons. We'll head into the top of the eighth inning with the Falcons leading over Folsom Lake 9-0.
Hi, my name is Jackson Berry. Thank you for watching the Solano College Sports Network.
We head to the top of the eighth. Mason Allen, the catcher, coming up for Folsom Lake. He'll be followed by Nick Schumacher, and then K.O. Leach. Jordan Chana on the mound, second inning of work, catches the outside corner for a strike. Jordan Chana, just a freshman. He's been pretty effective this year.
And very effective today. I'm thinking Poff would be in March. You found a foolproof way to enjoy the NCAA tournament.
That one over for a strike. Nice pitch. Yeah, we got March Madness starting tomorrow.
Right, but your secret is you don't fill out a bracket.
No, because then you can just enjoy the games.
Right.
Then I find myself rooting for a team that I really want the other team to win.
Yeah.
That
like
pitch
that.
Outside for and high for a ball. But a lot of fun doing that. Most people like filling out brackets.
Yeah.
In fact, a lot of people fill out multiple brackets.
Yeah.
All right. Chana set. That one is ripped, but right to the first baseman. Stover grabs it, touches the bag, 2 outs.
Now batting, number 33, Reed Ramirez.
So Reed Ramirez coming up. Pinch hitter out of Vacaville High School. Reed Ramirez, an outstanding football player at Vacaville High School.
Did you cover some of the games? Yeah.
Last 2 years, wide receiver, outside linebacker. Yeah. This kid gets after it. Gets after that one, but lifts it high to center field. Noble coming over. Right fielder Phipps coming over. He says, I got it, and makes the catch. And that'll be the second out. Got a little ahead of myself.
But no, you,
I'm trying to read Tristan's book here, though. He didn't write down what Tyler Cam, the right fielder. I think he had the last out
right in
the seventh inning. You don't have a scorebook, do you?
No,
how are you announcing a game without a scorebook?
I guess I got to start doing that.
You got to start doing that. That way you know what's going on.
That way I can back you up.
And then I can cheat off of yours.
Exactly. No, I let you down, Poff.
That's all right, baby. All right, up now, Cale Leach, the third baseman. Thank you, McKenna. Grounded out to first. Our crack dugout reporter, she knows what's going on. Nice job. That one fouled back out of play. So Jordan Chana yet to give up a hit. Five retired by Chana. Swing and a miss there. And Chana comes in with an ERA of 13.50.
I think it's going down.
A couple rough innings early in non-conference play when they're playing a lot of those tough teams like Santa Rosa, San Mateo, Delta. Boy, you look at that non-conference schedule for the Falcons. Murderous.
Yeah.
That's a high pop fly. We'll see if it drifts out. No, Stover over, and he's got it. That'll do it. Three up, three down. Jordan Chana's retired six in a row. So Reed Ramirez will stay in the game for the Falcons. He'll be at first base. And now leading things off for the Falcons as we head to the bottom of the eighth inning, Evan Fasenda. Oh, not so fast. Alex Nesikevich coming up. So he'll be batting in place of Evan Fasenda to get things started here in the bottom of the eighth inning. Alex Nesikevich, a sophomore for the Falcons. Excellent center fielder. Has struggled at the plate at times, so an opportunity for the freshman to get something going for the Falcons here. And we all know no lead is safe in community college baseball. All right, so the left-hand hitting Nesikevich takes that one in the dirt for a ball.
We don't want it to happen, but with the daylight savings time, there is time for
plenty of time, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
All right, Stafford still on the mound. Next pitch, low and away for a ball. So good eye by Nesikevich. Two balls, no strikes. Stafford looks in, gets his sign. Pitching out of the stretch, and the pitch. Half swing, yep, he did go around. That'll be strike one, two balls, one strike. Nesikevich coming into today's game, hitting 111. Like to bump that up a little bit with a hit right here, and it's a chopper foul over to the first base side of play. Hope you're enjoying today's game, and today's game is sponsored by JamesThomasMedia.com, your stop for all your video production needs. JamesThomasMedia.com. All right. Stafford had to tie his shoelace. He looks like he's set. There you get a good look at Nesakevich. Stafford out of the stretch and the pitch. Breaking ball, swing and a miss by Nesakevich. That'll even the count. That'll do it.
Yeah.
Fouled that one back. Strike three. Nesakevich will walk back to the dugout, and now Jesse Phipps coming up to the plate.
Now batting, right fielder, number 14, Jesse Phipps.
So Phipps, pretty good day today. 2-for-4, a single double, 2 runs, and 2 RBIs. Getting to start in right field today.
A lot of twos there.
Deuces wild. Phipps set. Fouls that one back out of play.
He didn't have, I think it was in the first inning, he dropped that the pop fly there, but that's long since forgotten. Ancient history.
So Phipps, the sophomore, good sophomore campaign. Here's the pitch, way outside for a ball. Phipps entered today's game hitting 268. And that would have been Phipps' first error on the season.
Okay, yeah.
Very good defensive player. Usually he's going to play in left.
That's also
half swing. That's going to get out to the shortstop. Fields it on a hop. Low throw, but the first baseman digs it out. That's Reed Ramirez, who just came in. So that'll retire Phipps.
You're going to give Phipps a little bit of a pass playing out of position there, right field. No puff, we're doing the baseball today. We talk about the sports broadcasting. We also do in the softball, basketball, and in fact you did some high school football. That's how you knew the Vacaville players.
Yeah, unfortunately no football program here at Solano. Yeah. So for all you guys to get experience doing football games, we typically cover both the Vacaville Bulldogs and the Will Seawood Wildcats.
Yeah.
So Nolan Burr coming up. He's hitting in place of Joey Dodson. I get a sneaky feeling Joey D might be our player of the game today.
He
got to finish this one out, and Burr, first pitch, hits it back behind the box. Second baseman gets over there, but throw not in time, and a little gymnastics roll by Nolan Burr. Let's give him a 10. Now probably a 9. Didn't stick the landing.
Yeah, the French judge did not give him a 10.
Nice effort by the shortstop, Joseph Smith, and good hustle by Nolan Burr, the kid out of Santa Cruz. All right, regulators, mount up. Here comes Briar Litz. He just doesn't seem like the type of kid that's going to come out to Warren G.
Yeah, I'm impressed. You know, I mean, we could probably talk music from the 60s and 70s, and you also know Warren G. That's impressive.
Oh, yeah. You know my favorite rapper is?
MC Hammer?
No, Kendrick Lamar, baby. Come on.
You got to laugh from the people here. You're going to have to educate me on Kendrick Lamar.
You're kidding.
You know, I know about, like, Outkast.
You're the one who's old.
Yeah, exactly.
Come on.
Yeah, I got to get with the times.
All right, back to the game. Stafford said, here's the pitch. Litz fouls that one back. He was trying to do some damage there.
That'll be my homework, Poff. I'll go home and learn about Kendrick Lamar.
He was swinging at that one like he was Nate Dogg coming up to help out Warren G. and LBC, baby.
That I know about. The 2-1-2. I can hang a little bit.
All right. Stafford set. And the pitch. Litz hits this one. Back up the box into center field. Base hit. So give Briar Litz another hit on the day. That's 2 for him. Nolan Burr gets down to second. Okay. And Luke Noble coming up to the plate. There you get a nice look on the replay.
Center fielder.
Just a nice, clean single.
Luke Noble.
So the center fielder, Luke Noble, coming up to the plate. There you get a good look at the left-handed hitter. 1-for-3 today. double, three RBIs. Here's the pitch. And he rips this one. That's going to get in. Oh, diving stop by the second baseman. Gets under his mitt out into right field. Here comes Burren. He's going to score. Put another one on the board for the Falcons.
10-0.
So Stafford, after retiring the first two batters, gives up a base hit to Nolan Burr, another single to Briar Litz, and another hit by Luke Noble. Good enough to put another run on the board. And there you get a look at the replay just under the dive of the second baseman.
Well, this is the theme of the day, the two-out hitting by the Falcons. I mean,
boy, and that's what cost him yesterday in that game against Laney. They had that one bad inning. I think it was the fourth inning where Laney was able to put four on the board, all with two outs.
But there could be redemption tomorrow. It's almost like the major leagues, three games in a row.
So there's a pop-up. Third baseman settles under it and makes the catch. That was Brandon Donnelly up at the plate for the third out. So now we go to the bottom of the ninth inning. And let's see who's going to come on the mound. Let's see if we're going to go with Jordan Chana or with Jay Wagner. We'll be right back with the bottom of the ninth.
I'm Jordan Chana, and thank you for watching the Solano College Sports Network.
Folks, let me make a big correction. We now head to the top of the ninth inning. That's now, used to coming out of the bullpen, I'm usually a starter.
That's it. I mean, but you're a well-rounded individual.
I'm not used to pitching out of the stretch.
No.
All right, so Jordan Chana on the mound for his third inning of work.
No, but we brought you into a game here where there's less pressure with it being 9-0, now 10-0. But that's a credit to Solano today. Just really played fantastic game at the plate and pitching.
So Jacob Alvarez, he'll be up hitting in place of Greg Vaughn, facing Jordan Chana. First pitch and rips this one foul, and it hit the third base coach.
Yeah.
Right between the shoulder blades. Gives a little smile down to the hitter, Alvarez. Sorry, coach. So no balls, one strike. Yeah. Jacob Alvarez, 5'11", 190-pounder, just a freshman. Went to Pleasant Grove High School.
As you said, no lead is safe in community college, but I'm going to say we're safe today, maybe.
Well, we'll see.
We'll see. I should stop talking about these type of things.
Don't jinx them.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
So Alvarez fouls that one back. No balls, two strikes. So Chana head in the count is yet to give up a hit. Six up, six down. That one hit off Chana's glove, but it goes right to the second baseman. Burn, nice throw, and gets him.
Looks like pinball out there.
So Nolan Burn now at second in place of Joey D. And up to the plate. Another pinch hitter, number 34, Tyler Maria. All right. Sean is set. And the pitch. Fouled back out of play. So Maria, pretty big kid, 5'11", 205-pounder.
He doesn't miss too many dinners.
Went to Pleasant Valley High School in Chico, California.
Yeah.
Just a freshman.
Hey, a couple guys from Pleasant Valley.
That pitch inside for a ball.
You know, did Aaron Rodgers go to Pleasant Valley?
What's that?
Aaron Rodgers, I think, the football player.
Yeah, I know he went to Butte Community College.
That's the part I knew for sure, but I think at Pleasant Valley, then he grew.
Won a state championship in football at Butte.
Right.
That one is hit to the shortstop Webster. Okay. Throw over to Donnelly at first.
Yeah, Cal went up to Butte to recruit the tight end, and then they said, who's this guy throwing the passes?
So two up, two down. Jordan Chana has now retired 8 batters in a row.
This could be it.
And now coming up to the plate, another pinch hitter, number 12, Troy Zier. 6'2", 195-pounder. Went to Ponderosa High School. And here's the pitch. This one's lifted foul. Looks like this is going to get out of play.
Wow.
Donnelly hustling over there.
The sound effects came in early.
So today it's been all about the pitching.
It has.
For the Falcons.
Yeah.
Outstanding start by Jackson Berry, and then Chana comes in. And
yeah, we can't get ahead of ourselves, but the combined shutout, and that's very, very impressive.
And Folsom Lake, this is a hot team.
Yeah, Tristan and I talked about that. Yeah. Schumacher is one of the best players in the state. Here we
Chopper
go.
To Pridey, fields it on a hop. Throw over in time, and that'll do it. Big time victory for the Solano Falcons. They had that tough loss yesterday. They had to go to Laney and face one of the better pitchers in all of Northern California. Lost that game, but come back to the confines of Billy and Louise Yarborough Stadium and able to put a win on the board. That'll be their third conference victory to go with 2 defeats. And now we're going to throw it out to the field to McKenna Guerrero with today's player of the game, Joey Dodson.
Hey guys, I'm McKenna Guerrero with the Solano College Sports Network, and I'm here with our Best Buy player of the game, Joey Dodson. Joey, normally you lead off, and today you drop down to the third. What was it like making that adjustment? How did you prepare for today's game?
Honestly, I didn't even know I was going to bat third today. I came today thinking I was going to bat first. Worked on it all week last week, just staying with our approach, staying up the middle, and today we executed really well.
Today you had 3 singles, 3 RBIs, a double, and 1 run scored in. What sparked your motivation today?
Yesterday we lost, took a really bad L to Laney yesterday. They threw a lefty, they came out with another lefty today. Stay with our approach like we should have did yesterday. Stay hard up the middle, nice, good approach.
And looking back on your non-conference games and now it being conference, what have you learned not only about yourself, but about your team as well?
Our team, we know we're fighters. We had a really tough preseason, like you said. San Mateo, Delta, they're really good teams. We just didn't play our game. Today we played our game, and for myself, I don't know. I'm just bonded with all the guys. One guy gets a hit, it's a rally.
And what are you going to take from today's game and bring it to tomorrow against Laney?
Yeah, same thing. Stay with our approach. Stay hard up the middle. Just come out with another victory.
Well, thank you, Joey. Congratulations and good luck tomorrow.
Solano
did a great job, got on top early, and had a shutout against Folsom. Final score ending 10-0. Thank you. I'm McKenna Guerrero, and thank you for supporting the Solano College Sports Network. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.